Mines. This morning's Tony McClure. Tony, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
An update from you this week, Tony, on Bowdens, the increase in gold and zinc you're seeing here in your drill program. Give us a bit of an update.
Thanks. As you know, the main project is very much silver, and we've got a vast resource there that we're undergoing development approvals at the moment. But underneath that, we've been doing a huge amount of drilling, and we still see a lot of silver, of course, but we see a higher tenor of gold and zinc and lead coming into the picture. Particularly gold is topical for us. So that drilling is certainly surprising all of us at Bowdens, and we're still drilling it out. We've got four rigs on site. We're spending about $1 million a month on drilling. So it's a very intensive effort, and that's reflective of the results we're getting and the attraction of the project. Is this thing just keeps growing, and to see other commodities coming into play is particularly important. It's a very, very large mineral system, and we still don't know the extent of it.
Hmm. Talk us through some of the latest results that you've seen here.
Well, I think the topical one is what we're seeing in gold, and we have seen gold in the past in small amounts here and there in the silver deposit. But to see an intercept, albeit low grade at 0.3 grams per tonne, but over 100 metres, and well over 100 metres, that is something that's very topical for us. So it's showing that we're getting into a hotter part of the system. We're seeing a little bit of copper in the system as well, seeing higher grade zinc, so less silver. But this zone we're drilling at the moment, called Bundara, which is directly under the current resource, is showing different attributes which are particularly attractive, and of course with a large tenor of gold in there that's puts a very different perplexion on the economics of the project.
Mm. How's the underground scoping study? How's work on that progressing?
Yeah, so we actually deferred the completion of that just because the drilling has been doing so well, and we're still drilling out particularly the Bundara area, as I've just been talking about. So that the cutoff for the resource assessment is under review at the moment. We're not going to be stopping the drilling, of course, but we're hoping to get a resource assessment out in the second quarter, so over the next couple of months, and that will flow through into the completion of the scoping study. Ordinarily, you would complete the drill out, do the resource assessment, and then do the scoping study. We've gone about the other way around, just because the results have been so good and positive, and so we commenced the scoping study last year. We got a fair way down the track, and then as the resource drilling continued, we decided to put the completion of the scoping study out until that was done. But they're good problems to have when you haven't hit the extent of the mineralized system. So we've got some good news coming out on that in the next couple of months, that's for sure.
What about the approvals, Tony, for mine development?
So for the open cut development, we're at the very pointy end of that. So that's been going on for some time now. The economic assessment was completed some years ago. That went moved into the environmental reporting and so forth. We did our hopefully final submissions just last week. So and that will go through its regular process. But we expect we'll have approvals sometime during the second half of this year.
And meanwhile, how's the silver market holding up?
Well, silver's, like most commodities, is doing very well, and it's sitting around $25 an ounce at the moment. We did our assessments on the mine development at about $20 an ounce. We've seen it. There's a lot of positive predictions out there over $30 an ounce. I think silver's, like most commodities, is continuing on in boom times, and we're obviously very comfortable with that.
Mm. You have said, Tony, but just give us, for the sake of a recap here, what the near-term news flow is looking like for you?
So the drilling continues, of course, with the four rigs on site, and that's a fairly intensive drilling program. And those discoveries we made directly under the resource are obviously very topical for us, and that flows through into the resource assessment underneath there, scoping study, drilling, of course. But I think a big ticket item for us is the mine development approval, and we're not seeing any impediment for that. And we're looking forward. We're in the pre-planning phase for the big silver mine development. So it's all systems go for us.
Good to see you. Thanks for your time.
Cheers, Andrew. Thank you.